Hey there, this is your pal Pally, and welcome back to Get a Raid. This is Tier 15 Heroic Throne of Thunder, and next up is Megara. If you liked your 3 hits from normal mode, how about a 4th? This fight is usually a 2 tank and seems to be a 3 heal fight as well. Although I've seen that 1 tanking can also work if you're very careful about positioning of the tank and melee. So yes, there is another head to deal with in this fight, and another mechanic that goes with it. It is an arcane head, and it will spawn on the far left side of the lake here. It has a breath attack as usual. It's not too big of a deal, but realize that the debuff that gets placed on the tank for this breath will distribute a certain percentage of healing that is directed at the tank to the raid. Not a bad debuff, but it does mean that the tank will receive less healing overall. The mechanic that goes along with the arcane head is some adds called netherworms. They have only 2 attacks. The first is a nether spike, which is just an arcane blast directed at its target. The more annoying attack is suppression. This one will stun their target for a full 8 seconds. It must be interrupted as soon as it happens, given all the other crap going on in this fight. So how do you deal with these adds? Well, for the most part, our group decided to use some AoE CCs and just keep them locked down until we got to the point of a rampage, and then we would cleave them off as we worked on the next head. It helps to have some people focus them for a little bit before turning to the boss, as they can get stuck in CCs and you'll need a ranged interrupt to group them up. That's really all there is different for heroic mode for this fight. The strategy does change, but it's fairly simple. Don't ever kill the green head. The AoE coming down from having killed the green head just seriously complicates everything else in the fight, so most groups will just kill any non-green head. So you'll kill the red head first, then blue, then arcane, then back to red, blue, arcane, and finally blue for head number 7. You will have to watch any tank that is tanking the green head, as it will still get its damage buff for each time you kill a head. So by the end, that will be at least 100% more attack speed on the green head. And I lied. There are a few more differences to note, but they aren't game-changing. Cinders will now create a pool of flame every 3 seconds, as opposed to only creating a pool when the target is dispelled. So if you aren't quick, you'll have many pools per cinders. Likewise, the torrent of ice is a little different. The icy ground that remains after a torrent passes will grow to about double its size before it disappears, so this just means you have less room to maneuver. One big note here on positioning. When we get to the arcane head, we have the tank point the head inward instead of out. You can see the star marker here. This let us use all of this room close to the lake to drop cinders and ice torrents, which is a huge help in terms of available space. Obviously, your melee have to realize the boss is pointed in a different direction and adjust, and also the tank way on the other side at green should probably make sure to point that head away some so as to not get hit with the arcane breath, but that's a slim chance anyway. So, have fun killing heads, CC adds, and place your ice and fire crud carefully, and you'll get this encounter down. Thanks for watching, and please comment, like, and/or subscribe to the video if you found it helpful, and have a good one.